Let us do the most important questions from the miscellaneous exercise, that is D exercise. Let us try our hands on those questions which are asked in the board's exam to get an understanding as to what is expected out of us in the board's exam. That means having knowledge of addition, subtraction, types of matrices and the multiplication. If I have the knowledge, if I am going through all these things, whether I'll be able to solve the types of the questions that will be asked in the board exams, the answer is definitely yes. And you can get to know by going through the following examples that I'll be doing with you. Selectively, I am choosing the questions from exercise 9B, that is a miscellaneous exercise. Almost all the questions, those are asked in the board's exams, so that we can predict and understand the nature of the questions and also understand whatever you have done, is that enough to solve the questions? To all your queries, let us go to exercise 9D. These are the selected questions from exercise 9D, which is a miscellaneous exercise and one of the most simplest exercise so far. From the level of you can say difficulty, you will be able to gauge how easy these questions are, the one which were asked in the board exams. Analyze them properly for your understanding. Matrix A, matrix B, matrix C given to us. There are two unknowns, P and minus Q. What they have mentioned is find P and Q if matrix BA. So matrix BA equals to C square. Can you find matrix BA? Sir, we can multiply. And what about C square? Sir, matrix C into C will be C square. So BA C into C would be C square. I need to find the value of matrix B. That would be 0, minus Q, 1 and 0. I have substituted. What about matrix A? B, 0, 0 and 2. What about matrix C? So matrix C would be 2, minus 2, 2 and 2. Here also 2, minus 2, 2 and 2. Focus on this side, can we multiply? So the order is 2 into 2, we can multiply. 0 into P, 0. 0 into P, minus Q into 0, that is also 0. Again the same row, the next column. 0 into 0, 0, minus Q into 2, minus 2Q. This row into this column, this row into this column, done. Move on to the next row. So you come down. 1 into P, P, plus 0 into 0, 0. 1 into 0, 0, 0 into 2, that is also 0, equals to, here multiplication possible, 2 into 2, 4, 2 into 2, 4, plus, minus 2 into 2, minus 4, next, 2 into minus 2, minus 4, plus, so we did this into this, already done, this into this one, 2 into minus 2, minus 2 into 2, minus 4, 2 into 2, 4, plus 2 into 2, 2 into minus 2, minus 4, plus 2 into 2, 4. When you compare 0, minus 2q, p, 0, is equal to 4 plus minus 4, 0, minus 4 plus minus 4, minus 8, 8. 0. See, 0, 0 is compared to 0, 0. P is equal to 8. Minus 2Q can be written as minus 8. Therefore, Q equals to 4. Isn't it very simple, my dear friends? This was the question asked for 3 marks in the board's exam. Simple multiplication, everything given, you have to operate only on this. Move on to the next question, that is question number 19. Now, see question number 19. Everything is given to you. You only have to multiply it and put it in a proper perspective. AB, the order of A, B is material,
plus 2c minus 4d. I have to find that. So let us put the value of A matrix. 3, minus 2, minus 1, and 4. B matrix. Do we have B matrix? 6 plus 2 times C matrix. Minus 4. Minus 4 times D matrix. Do we have D matrix? Yes, sir. We do have D matrix. That is 2 and 2. AB plus plus 2, 2, CC. Minus 4, minus 4, D. We have to find AB plus 2, C minus 4, D. They are all properly arranged. Now, only this matrix you have to verify. Rest all is very simple. The order is 2 into 2. The order is 2 into 1. So, of course, that means the resulting matrix will have two rows and only one single column. Let us see how it looks. 3 into 6, 18. Not yet done. 3 into 6 minus 2 into 1. This into this done. We are taking the next row. So come down. Minus 6 plus 4. Plus. Can you insert this two? Of course, sir. I will insert 4 inside, so if you multiply with each element, it becomes 8. So what is the resulting matrix, my dear friends? 18 minus 2, 16, minus 6 plus 4, minus 2, minus 8, 10, 8, 8. Let us find out the resulting. 16 plus minus 8, minus 8, minus 2, plus 10, minus 8. That gives me 0, 0. That's the null matrix. It was so simple and easy, my dear friends. That means getting marks out of the matrices chapter is really, really simple and manageable. So you can assume that you get an insurance of 6 marks for this chapter, and you are bound to get these marks in the exam. Have a look at this question. Again, since A is available, we can find the value of A square, which is A into A. Can you find 5A? Yes, sir. Can you find 7I? Yes, sir. How do you find 7I? So 7I would be 7 and 1, 0, 0, 1. So basically, you are going to substitute A into A matrix, of course, minus 5 into A matrix, of course, plus 7I. I'm sure you can do this question for very, very simple reasons. Same thing over here as well. A, so you can find out A square. So first thing is you find out A square. Then you find out B square. Manageable? Yes, sir. Manageable? Yes, sir. Since after finding this, you need to find out A square minus 5B square. That should be your LHS. After finding this, find RHS. 5 into matrix C. Compare. If they are same, that means yes, we have proved it. All the questions were targeted towards 2 by 2 matrix. The grid was 2 by 2 in each and everything. Or else maybe lesser than that. So that means the questions were quite simple. Now we are left with only one single variety of question. To find an unknown matrix. I am going to do 3 to 4 such sums, and those the type of questions which I am going to do right now, that is the most difficult level according to them, and we don't have any level beyond that. We are in the last phase of matrices, and trust me, this phase is also very, very simple. Most of the questions are monotonous, they are not difficult at all, but students have generally been asking or probably having their maximum number of queries related to this type of questions. So what I have done is I have segregated all the same type of questions belonging to this category into one, and we are going to discuss on the same. Have a look over here. This is question number 70 9c 70. We have a matrix F which we don't know. Multiply by A matrix. The order is 2 into 2. and the resulting matrix is of the order 1 row and 2 column. Now, supposing if I have a matrix A multiplied by matrix B gives me a resulting matrix C. You know how it works? If I ask you what is the order of matrix A, let us say 2 into 2. What about the order of matrix B? Let us say 2 into 2. These two will always be the same, only then matrix multiplication is possible. So these two will always be the same, always be the same. And what about the resulting matrix? My resulting matrix will be the outcome of the product of the first and the last. Now what is the first and the last number? So 2 into 2. So it's going to be like that. Take another example. Let us say I have a matrix A, which is of the order 3 into 2. I have another matrix B, which is of the order 2 into 3. What will be the resulting matrix? So these two has to be the same. So resulting matrix will always be the first and the last. That means it will be of the order 3 into 3. So one thing is certain, these two will also always be the same, and this into this will result in the resulting matrix. If you know this concept, actually you know the concept, but then if you know this, the way it functions, you will find it extremely easy to solve the questions pertaining to this type of category. Here we have to find what? Find matrix M. Do you know the order of matrix M? Sir, I don't know the order of matrix M. Let the order of matrix M be rows into column. We don't know. So basically, matrix M, row into column, multiply by matrix this, 1, 2, 0, 2. What is the order of this matrix? So 2 into 2 will give me the resulting matrix. What is the order of the resulting matrix, my dear friends? So resulting matrix have order 1 row and 2 columns. Fantastic. If you see this equation, this 2 has to be same. So sir, C will be equal to 2. And if you see, R into 2 should be equal to 1 into 2, that is this. Product of this two has to be the resulting matrix. So if you see, how many rows? 1 row. How many column? 2 column. Therefore, matrix M will be of the order. What order? 1 into 2. 1 row and 2 column. I don't have matrix M, but I can make it. So let matrix M be 1 row and 2 columns. We have 1 row and 2 columns. One more time, my dear friends. Matrix M multiplied by this matrix will give me the resulting matrix. I don't have the order of matrix M. What I do, let the order of matrix M be row into column. So row into column. Matrix M multiplied by this matrix equals to this. What is the order of this matrix? 1 into 2. Order of this? 2 into 2. Order of this? R into C. For the multiplication to be possible, this 2 has to be the same. So C will be equal to 2. The resulting matrix order will always be the product of these two extremes. Smile, man, smile. There is no pressure. So better smile. Yes, 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 smile. So row into column, R into 2 will give you 1 into 2. 2, 2 cancels, R is 1. So that means 1 row, 2 column, matrix M will have 1 row and 2 column. Once you are through this, the question is done. I hope and I am assuming that this is absolutely done. Now what? Since we know that matrix M, that means let matrix M be A and B. Let us start. A, B, 1, 2, 0, 2 equals to 1 and 2. Let us multiply this row into this column. So the row into the column, A, not yet over, plus, so this into this, done. Next, this into this, 2A plus 2B. There won't be anything else, sir. There won't be a second row. There is only one row, so the resulting matrix will have only one row. So what do you get? So 1, 2, so we have A, 2A plus 2B equals to 1 and 2. Compare it. A equals to 1, 2A plus 2B equals to 2. Substitute A equals to 1, therefore 2 into 1 plus 2B equals to 2. 2B plus 2 equals to 2, 2 cancels, 2B equals to 0, therefore B equals to 0. Therefore, matrix M, which was AB, is now going to become A is 1 and B is 0. If you wish, after finding the value of matrix M, you can verify also. Have a look, matrix M is 1, 0. So 1, 0 multiply by matrix 1, 2, 0, 2. Let us see how much do you get. What is this matrix? Sir, 1 row, 2 column. 2 row, 2 column. Possible. The resulting matrix will have only 1 row. 1 into 1, 1. Plus 0 into 0, 0. So this into this is done. Further, 1 into 2, 2. Plus 0 into 2, 0. So you get the answer as 1 and 2. Check it out. So wasn't it simple? Let us have few more examples to solve the same type of questions. Little bit here and there, but more or less would be the same. Yeah. So this was question number 17. My second question would be question number again 9C, question number 17, second part. The question is 1, 4, 2, 1. Multiply by matrix M and the resulting matrix is 13 and 5. So we don't know what is the order of matrix M. So what is the order of this matrix? 2 multiply by 2. Let the order of M be equals to row into column. So here the order would be row into column. That will be equal to, please can you tell me what is the order? Sir, 2 row and 1 column. Excellent. For the multiplication to be possible, can I say my R should be equal to, because this 2 has to be the same. Therefore, rows will be 2. As far as columns are concerned, can I say 2 multiply by, that means the product of the extremes, smile, reason to smile. Product of the extremes should be same as the order of the resulting matrix. 2, 2 cancels, therefore number of column will be 1. Therefore, order of matrix M is nothing but row into column. How many rows? 2 and column. So let matrix M be how many rows? Sir, 2 rows. 2 rows and 1 single column. Now you need to substitute this over here. So basically you get 1, 4, 2, 1. Matrix A, B should give you 13 and 5. You can check it. 2 into 2. 2 into 1, 2, 2 cancel, resulting 2 into 1. Perfect. How do we go about, sir? 1, you must understand the resulting is 2 row and 1 column. So you are going to get 2 rows. 1, 1 into A, not yet over, plus 4 into B, 4B. This into this, done. Moving to the next row, so you have to come down. 2 into A, 2A, plus 1 into B, B, will give you how much? 13, 5. If you compare A plus 4B equals to 13, 2A plus B equals to 5. This becomes a simultaneous equation. Simple one. Can I multiply the first equation by 2? Yes, sir. 2A plus B equals to 26. 2A plus B equals to 5. If you solve them, change the signs, 26 minus 5, 21. A to B minus B, 7b. Therefore, b equals to 3. Once you know the value of b equals to 3, you can substitute a plus 4 into b, 4 into 3 equals to 13. A plus 12 equals to 13, a equals to 1. What we are interested in? Sir, we are interested in finding out matrix M. What was the value of matrix M? Sir, A and B. Can we substitute the values? Yes, sir. A is 1 and B is 3. So, all the questions are going to be of the same to same type. No change at all. If you know how to deal with this type of questions, then these are the host of all the questions. Have a look over here, my dear friends. Question number 25. Question number 4, question number 6, they are all of the same type, same to same. I'm doing few of them. Have a look at question number 25, my dear friends. A, 2, 1, 1, 3. Matrix X, I don't know. So the order of this is 2 into 2. The order of this matrix, which we don't know, is let us say row into column, will give me the resulting matrix. 3 minus 11. What is the order of this matrix? Sir, 2 row and 1 column. Since we know that these two need to be same, therefore R would be 2. We also know that the end, reason to smile, that means 2 into C should always be equal to 2 into 1. So 2, 2 cancels, therefore C equals to 1. So matrix X will always be of row into column, which is 2 into 1. So let matrix X have 2 rows and 1 column. Now same way what we did earlier, you can perform your operation and get your desired answer. 2, 1, 1, 3. What about X? I found out by giving you the same commentary as what I have told you earlier also. A, B, started. As you know, order is 2 into 2, order is 2 into 1, 2, 2 cancel. The resulting will have 2 row and 1 column. Already given to us. 2 into A, 2A, not yet done. 2A plus B. A plus 3B. You get two simultaneous equations, 2A plus B equals to 3. A plus 3b equals to minus 11. Apply, supply. Get the reply. Get the value of a and b. Substitute over here and you find the value of x. This is one similar question. 9b, question number 6. 3a multiplied by matrix m. We don't know matrix m. Equals to 2b. 3a, matrix a is given to us. 3 to 0, 0. Minus 3, 12, minus 9. Matrix M, we have no clue, no idea. And this will give you minus 10 and 12. We want to find out the order of matrix M. We don't know. So let us assume that the order is row into column. Can you tell me what is the order of this matrix, sir? 2 into 2. Order of this matrix, row into column. Order of this, sir, this is the resulting matrix. And the resulting matrix, you can find out the order, it's given to us 2 row and 1 column. This should always be equal to this, therefore my R equals to 2. 2 into C, product of extreme, will be equal to the resulting matrix. Row into column equals to 2 into 1. 2, 2 cancels, so column is 1. So matrix M will have 2 row and 1 column. That is what we found out. So let matrix M be 2 rows. So we have 2 rows and 1 single column. So 2 rows, row 1, row 2 and 1 single column. Now you can substitute over here. So basically what you get is 0 minus 3, 12 minus 9 multiply by A, B gives you minus 10, 12. Since this is 2 into 2, 2 into 1, resulting is 2 into 1. So my resulting matrix will have two rows. Let us start. 0 into A, 0. Minus 3 into B, minus 3B. Done. This is 12. 12 into A, 12A. Minus 9B will give you minus 10 and 12. On comparison, you can easily get the value of B. 0 minus 3b equals to minus 10. Minus 3b equals to minus 10. B equals to 10 upon 3, which is 1 upon 3. You can substitute the value of B in this. So 12a minus 9b equals to 12. So 12a minus 9 into 10 upon 3 equals to 12. 3 ones are, 3 threes are. 12a equals to 30. 30 goes that side. 12 plus 30, 42. 12a equals to 42. A equals to 42 upon 12. 6 twos are, 6 sevens are. Therefore, a equals to 3.5. So, my dear friends, solve the questions. 1, 2, 17C. This is C exercise, question number 17, 1 and 2. Question number 25, again you have a C exercise over here. 9D, question number 4, and question number 6. With this, your entire matrices chapter comes to an end. I'm sure the chapter was easy. The chapter is such that you can complete in 2 hours. Your revision will not take much of your time. Focus should be only on multiplication properties. Rest are all very much simple and within the domain of operations of plus, minus, multiplication, and division. Thank you so much for watching the videos and giving your suggestions from time and again. I thank you so much for your cooperation in these years. Wish you a very good luck and a good health. Goodbye.